Thank you, Commissioner, for all your input. And I'd like to emphasize, too, as Commissioner Hewitt has put on board and with this information, that there's something that we've been dealing with in Annapolis for years that I've been here, they're called the Kerwin Commission. This is sort of the footprint of the state of Maryland on schools, what they look forward to as improving our educational system to a really high level. And we sort of agree on some of these terms, but I just want to remind everybody and remind even Dr. Smith that Maryland has 24 jurisdictions, 23 counties, and the city of Baltimore. So we had 24 jurisdictions. There's only a small handful, I think the last I heard was only about three, that have actually met the goals of this Kerwin Commission already. And St. Mary's County is one of them. Because this setting, these last 6 years that I've been here, we have overfunded the MOE for the Board of Education every year by millions of dollars, not a few hundred thousand, by millions every year to meet this goal, because we value education here very much. I value education very much. That's why we're all here now. Education has led us all to a good quality of life, and I believe in that. And I have to scorn Mr. Smith for bringing these things up, what he's going to have to cut if we don't give this additional $3.2 million to him. And that is really a rude thing to do, as far as I'm concerned. And unfortunately, I've gotten some emails from some teachers who think and say, I deserve this pay raise. I can't qualify you that. I don't supervise you. It's up to the principals, the people you work for, to say what kind of pay you deserve. I have nothing to do with that. And to put out some of these emails, I appreciate, I have no problem. I've had over 200 of them myself. And like some of them have been a form letter. And we look at these, I read some of them. The form letter, I said, reading the first one, that's about enough. But you need to look ahead of how we've already done. They're not informing you. You're getting wrong information about how much we've already given to the public school system in St. Mary's County. A lot. And we continue to do. We've already overfunded maintenance of effort already. So I'm just letting you know that now, so that when the budget hearings come up the 11th and the 18th of May, I'm sure we're going to hear about this. We'll hear about the public hearing on the 27th. Fine. We're open for that. It was for us, for the public hearing. We put a proposed budget up. That's not the final budget. Proposed budget on the 11th and 18th of May, we'll be able to finally look at what information comes out on the 27th of April. The family that lost that young child, I grew up across the street from the grandfather and an uncle, Danny Raley, who was a commissioner for 12 years here, and great family. I'm really concerned about this. I hope that some resolution comes out of all this. It's too bad. And I don't know the child itself. I never met him. I don't know him. But I'm sure our investigations will come out and give a final resolution to everything that happened that day. And it's truly too bad what's happening. I mourn for the parents. I don't really know the parents. I know your grandfather. So I'm sorry to hear this. And believe me, my heart goes out and prayers go out to you. Talking about the fairgrounds again, I want to put a plug out. A lot of these organizations are moving their things forward. For example, I read one with the Lions Club is going to have their Crab Festival, I think, on the 1st of August at the fairgrounds, and we're planning to do that. But if it gets to the point we can't have it, so many people on the fairground, it's going to be a drive-through type thing. We're going to sell steamed crabs, and all the other concessionaires will be there to sell their products in a drive-through format is what we're looking at. But we're hoping that things will be fully opened up by that time, which I'm hoping for by the 1st of August. So let's have faith and continue wearing our masks, continue moving on to this COVID thing until we all get vaccinated. And I think we'll all get through this. So please hold on, and we'll be through it.